And whenever you're doing your head leveling, when it's a diamond plate or a TEQ-Lok, you want to make sure when you're leveling it, you're using the new plate. If you have a used plate, you can re-level it to that used plate too, but you always want to have the tooling you're going to be using on the plate when you level it. For example, if we take these off, this plate sits so much lower. So if you level your head to this and then you put diamonds on it, it will ride at a funny angle. So you want to make sure whatever tooling you're going to use on this, or the main tooling, whether it's TEQ-Lok, whatever, beads, put those tools on there, new ones, level your head that way, and then you'll be good to go. Every time you replace tools, it will wear nice and smooth. So you've just removed your shaft and you've ordered a new plate, whether it's a TEQ-Lok or a diamond plate like this one, and you want to take your shaft and your coupler and swap it over. So you're going to get an O-ring as well with this plate, and we're going to go ahead and show how we're going to remove that. So the first thing I would do is remove the shaft with the 3 Allen bolts, 6mm. And then your shaft should come out with a little twist. And then there's your O-ring. And we highly suggest anytime you buy a new plate, it comes with an O-ring. Go ahead and fish this O-ring off, put your new one on, and apply just a little bit of grease. Stay away from WD-40 and anything that could eat rubber. Just a simple axle grease or whatever you got in your shop's the best bet. So now that we got the shaft off, we're gonna go ahead and remove the coupler. Same style, 3 bolts, just going down vertically. Once you got your coupler off, you've got a 6-hole series on the top of this plate. You can use it in any series you want. So twist, turn, if you've got a bad, on the coupler, there is a right side up, right side down. These metal facings are towards the plate, and there's a recess for your bolt head on the top to where the bolt sits down inside. So you should be able to tell which way it goes on there. But as far as the holes it needs, you can twist it any way you need it. Say you've got some bad threads or whatnot, you can twist it and turn it however you need to. So we'll get these 3 bolts in. I just snug these down, not completely tight yet. And then we're gonna put our shaft in. Like I said, we're gonna put a little bit of grease on that, and that's just to help it get inserted in the plate. Little twist, little push, right in. And then we're gonna try and line up our 3 holes into our shaft from the side. And we're gonna start putting screws in, but we only wanna get a couple threads going. Because as you start putting these on, this coupler starts pulling in. And as each side pulls in, the last side gets further away. We're gonna go through and tighten all of them back down. And then we're gonna make sure we do our top ones to firm it up. Now this shaft's ready to be reinstalled into your unit.